Hello everyone. So after the huge response received from all of you for our first video, we are back again with the next video with a very new and frequently asked topic, miscarriages in early pregnancy. And we have with us Dr. Radhika Wagh from Blossom Swimmer Care, who will share some of her insights with us. Hello ma'am.
Thank you, Rishu. Hello, and hello everyone.
Shall we move ahead with the questions?
Sure. But before we move on to the questions, I would like to explain in short what exactly an early miscarriage means. Miscarriage, which is also known as spontaneous abortion or pregnancy loss, is the natural death of the embryo or fetus before it reaches a stage where it can survive and grow independently. Now, this is commonly seen up to 10 weeks of pregnancy, and hence we call it as an early miscarriage. All right. So yes, now we can go ahead with what questions you have received.
All right. So the most commonly asked question is, what are the possible reasons of an early miscarriage?
Well, like the definition says it, it's a natural death. So why would a natural death happen? Because there is some defect, deficit or damage which does not let the survival of this embryo or fetus happen. Hence, there is an end to it. The common reasons that we see are hormonal deficits, genetic defects, viral infections like TORCH, and in today's time, the most common reason that is found is stress.
Okay, so another question that we have with us is, I'm married since 8 months and recently had a miscarriage at 6 weeks. It made me very upset, and what are the chances that it may happen again?
All right. So firstly, 5 to 8 weeks is the commonest period where a miscarriage occurs. The causes I just mentioned, if any of those prevail, then nature itself does not let such a pregnancy go ahead, right? This is called as nature's natural filtration process. Please understand, the entire baby is made from one single cell, and this cell has a completely new genetic combination. One miscalculation can lead to a deformity or a defect, an abnormal child. So just imagine, if all such miscalculated pregnancies went ahead, we would be seeing a lot of physically and mentally challenged people around us. And how many such people do we actually see? Not many. So this is because of nature's filtration process. I would say don't feel bad about it. If it's happened, it's probably happened for the good. Now your query of whether it might happen again. If the cause prevails, yes, it might happen again. But the book says that we should not even investigate the cause unless there are 2 consecutive miscarriages. So my advice to you would be, just relax, be patient and try again anyways.
Alright, so to sum up, I would be interested in knowing, how can one prevent an early miscarriage?
Right. Frankly, early miscarriages are very common. About 40 to 50% of first conceptions end up in a miscarriage. It is just that with today's knowledge and available resources, it is diagnosed more easily than it used to be in the earlier days. Mm-hmm. Few simple tips like avoiding distant traveling, especially the ones that have jerks and bumps, avoiding lifting heavy weights, avoiding sexual contact. These few tips can reduce the risk of a miscarriage to some extent, but if the cause prevails, then it is going to happen anyways.
So now it's time to say goodbye to Dr. Radhika, but we'll definitely catch up with her again in our next video. Till then, please like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.